Hello friends, under accounting, under final account, today our topic is balance sheet. Balance sheet is the final phase in the accounting cycle. It is prepared on the last day of the accounting period, which could be a calendar year, which start from the 1st January ends on 31st December. So it is prepared on 31st December if the accounting period is calendar year. If the accounting period start from the 1st April ends on 31st March, so it is prepared on the 31st March. It is just like a mirror which shows the position, how much asset we have, how much liability we have. It is the statement of the balances which are not closed. It is generally prepared at the end of the accounting year. It shows the financial position, how much asset we have, how much liability we have. The balance sheet, as it is the statement of assets and liability, it shows the nature, whether it's a current asset, whether it's a fixed asset, what is the value of the asset. It indicates the quality and composition of the asset, nature and extent of the liability, short-term liability, long-term liability, and the owner's contribution. It also indicates the short-term solvency as well as the long-term solvency, as also it discloses the mix of debt and equity. So the balance sheet has two components, assets and liabilities. Asset, which is owned by the organization, which I will be explaining in the next slide. Asset could be fixed asset. Fixed asset could be tangible, intangible, contingent assets, current assets, fictitious asset. Liability means which we owe to others. It could be long-term liabilities, which are to be paid after 1 year. Current liabilities, which is to be paid within less than 1 year. Contingent liability, which is related to some future event. Contingent means which may happen, which may not happen. So long-term liabilities could be long-term loan, debentures. Current liabilities are those liabilities which are to be paid within less than 1 year. And liabilities are of two types, inside liability plus outside liabilities. Outside liability could be short-term as well as long-term liabilities. Inside liability means the capital which is contributed by the owner, because there is a difference between the owner and the business. So anything which owner brings in the business, that is called capital, and that is a liability for the business. So we will see what is the meaning of current assets. Current assets are those assets which are purchased for the purpose of resale and could be converted into cash immediately with less than 1 year. Current assets are those assets which are purchased for the resale, like we have a furniture shop, we buy the wood, convert it to furniture, then we sell it. Here the furniture is a current asset. And current assets are those assets which could be converted into cash immediately. Fixed assets are those assets which are not for the purpose of resale, but they create productive capacity, they generate earning capacity. Without the fixed asset, we cannot run the business. So there is a thin line between the current asset and fixed asset. If we have a furniture shop, here the furniture is current asset. But if we have a manufacturing organization, then furniture is a fixed asset. In the same case, if we manufacture machinery and resell it, then it is a current asset. But if we are using the machinery for the purpose of manufacturing, then it is a fixed asset. Fixed asset are those assets, these could be plant and machinery, building, freehold premises, leasehold premises, tools, etc. The example of the current assets: cash in hand, cash at bank, short-term investment, bill receivable, sundry debtors, closing stock, prepaid expenses, accrued income. Fixed assets are the long-term investments, furniture and fixture, freehold premises or leasehold premises, plant and machinery, building, loose tools, building and goodwill. That is the intangible asset. Fixed asset could be tangible. Tangible means which we could see, touch or feel, like furniture, land, plant and machinery, loose tools, building, etc. Intangible assets are goodwill, patents, trademarks, copyrights, etc. Contingent means which may or may not happen. Contingent asset is a possible asset that may arise because of the gain, which is contingent on the future event that is not under the entity's control, and accounting does not recognize them. Fictitious assets are without any concrete backing, like preliminary expenses, underwriting commission, discount on the issue of shares and debentures, and contingent liability, potential loss, which is contingent on the happening of some future event, like we may lose the lawsuit and we have to make the payment or penalty, then it is a contingent liability. Current liabilities are those liabilities which are to be paid within less than 1 year. Outstanding expenses, sundry creditors, bills payable, bank overdraft, if it is a temporary, if it is a permanent, then it is taken under long-term liability. Proposed dividend, income tax payable, short-term loan. And long-term liabilities, which are to be paid after 1 year, debentures, long-term loans, reserve, and capital. Marshalling of balance sheet means how we write the balance sheet, and it's very important. The component of the balance sheet should be presented in a particular manner. Permanence method, here the assets and liabilities which are of long-term nature, which are permanent, they are shown first and they are followed by the less permanent. Under the liquidity method, it is just the opposite of permanence method. Under this method, the asset which is having more liquidity, the asset which could be converted into cash without any convenience, without any problem, they will be shown first. Here the balance sheet is arranged on the basis of liquidity. It is prepared on the last day of the current period. Balance sheet of ABC Limited as on 31st March 2017. And this is the right hand side which shows the assets. It is on the liquidity basis. So liquid asset, they are shown first. Current asset, cash in hand, cash at bank, short term investments, bill receivables, sundry debtors, closing stocks, prepaid expenses. Then fixed asset, they are shown, long term investment or trade investments. Fixed assets, loose tools, livestock, motor vehicle, furniture, plant and machinery, land and building, patents, goodwills, and fictitious assets. In the same way, liabilities, they will also be shown under, they will be shown under the basis of liquidity. Short-term liabilities will be shown earlier, like current liabilities, income received in advance, outstanding expenses, bank overdraft, bill payable, sundry creditors, fixed liability, then long-term liabilities, fixed liabilities, long-term loans, reserve, general reserve, other specific reserve, and capital, and net profit is added and drawing is deducted. If the balance sheet is prepared on the basis of permanence method, then it will start from the goodwill, patents, building, land and machinery, plants, furniture, motor vehicle, livestock, loose tools. And the last item will be cash in hand. In the similar manner, the liability side will also start from the capital, long-term liabilities, then the short-term liabilities. Now we will do a question to understand the component of trading, profit and loss account, and balance sheet. Here, a trial balance is given and the closing stock is mentioned above or below. Closing stock is given 7,800. The closing stock, if it is given if it is given outside the trial balance, then it has to be taken in the trading account and also in the balance sheet. If it is given in the trial balance, then it will appear on the asset side of the balance sheet. When some question is given to make a trading account, profit and loss account, and balance sheet, first we have to identify what are the elements which belong to the trading account, what are the items which belong to the profit and loss account, what are the items which belong to the balance sheet. If we have this clarity, it is very easy to make the trading account, profit and loss account, and balance sheet. The items which belong to trading accounts, they are shown in the red ink, like opening stock, purchases, sales return, freight inward. If freight inward is there, carriage inward is there, cartage inward is there, it means it is related to the purchase or production. In the trading account, we take only those expenses which are related to the production and purchase. Purchase return, sales, and the closing stock which is given outside the trial balance. The item which belong to the profit and loss account, they are shown under the blue ink, rent and taxes, salary and wages, interest, postage, telegram, discount, legal charges, insurance, income from the investment, commission, and the office expenses. The items which belong to the balance sheet, they are expressed under the blank ink, sundry debtors, cash and bank, investments, furniture and fixtures, cash in hand, deposit withdrawal, drawings, capital, sundry creditors, and bank overdraft. So here the title is Trading and Profit and Loss Account for the year ending 2017. This is the debit side, this is the credit side, this is the income side, this is the right hand side. We record the incomes, and on the debit side, that is the left hand side, we record the expenses. So under the first entry of trading account is the opening stock, purchase, less purchase return to freight inward. Here, by sales, less sales return, by closing stock. Then under rough work, we calculate the total of credit side and calculate the total of debit side. As the credit side is greater than the debit side, because the total of credit side is 36,950 and debit side is 31,160, we calculate the difference, that is 5790. So we have gross profit that will be transferred to the profit and loss account, and it will appear on the credit side of the profit and loss account. Here also, on the credit side, we will write the income by gross profit, by income from the investments, by commission. And on the debit side, we will record all the expenses which are not which are related with the profit and loss account, which are indirect, which relate to the office expenses, selling and distribution, and which relate to the financial expenses. They will be recorded on the profit and loss account. To rent and taxes, salaries and wages, if wages and salaries are given, then it has to be taken into the trading account. Interest, postage and telegraph, to discount, office expense, legal charges, insurance. Then here we also, under rough, we calculate the total of credit side and the total of debit side. Credit side is bigger than the debit side, so difference is net profit. So we write on the debit side to net profit, that is transferred to the capital account. We have net profit to the tune of 2300. Now we will make a balance sheet. Balance sheet is prepared on the last day of the financial year. Balance sheet as on 31st March 2017. So the left hand side shows the liability and the right hand shows the assets. So it is made on the basis of liquidity. Liquid assets are written first, cash in hand, cash at bank, sundry debtors. As the closing stock, it appears outside the trial balance. So we are taking at the trading account as well as under the balance sheet. Deposits with RAM, investments, furniture and fixtures. So the total of assets is 19,700. So on the liability side, we write the current liabilities first, sundry creditors, bank overdraft as is taken as a short-term liabilities, capital, net profit is added and drawing is deducted. So we make a total of the liability side, that is 19,700. So total of assets should be equal to the total of liability.